morning, everybody. Welcome, wherever you may find yourselves. Welcome to this service on what is today the last of the great feasts before we get to Advent. It's Trinity Sunday, that mystery of our faith, where we celebrate Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So, to start, I'm going to ask you to join with me in an affirmation of our belief, our faith in the Trinity. I believe and trust in God the Father, who made the world. I believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ, who redeemed humankind. I believe and trust in his Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God. I believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise you, you servants of the Lord.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his name, now and forever.
To God in the highest, at peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us, you're seated at the right hand of the
say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just, and will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us. Pardon our sins and set us free from them. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and keep us in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We join together in the collect, the prayer for this Trinity Sunday. Eternal and infinite God, You have inspired us to acknowledge the glory of the Trinity and in your divine power to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith and unite us in your boundless love, that we may always praise you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 28, beginning at verse 16.
Glory to Christ our Saviour.
Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." This is the Gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
They worshipped him, but some doubted. Matthew 28:17. When it comes time to speak of God, especially God as Trinity, three persons and one essence, we always risk saying more than we really know or can ever know. That is the risk today on the Feast of the Holy Trinity, Trinity Sunday, as we would know. They worshipped him, but some doubted. That little phrase from today's gospel seems to me an accurate description of what often happens when we approach this God, whom the Church tells us is one God in three persons. Worship and doubt stand alongside each other. Today's gospel is a continuation of the Easter story. The disciples headed to Galilee, to a mountain that Jesus had directed them to. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. The NRSV Bible translates the Greek as "some doubted." However, a more literal translation of the Greek is "they doubted." It wasn't just some of them that doubted. I think all of them had doubts, even though they all worshipped. At some point, worship and doubt is intertwined. They doubted. This does not mean they had no faith or that they didn't believe. It just means they gave their hearts to him, but their heads couldn't make sense of what was happening. They were of two minds, and they were in some doubt. Their hearts and their heads were certainly not aligned. Part of the experience made sense, whilst the other part did not. The experience was real. The logic and the understanding, however, were unable to match the intensity and the reality of their experience. Who amongst us hasn't had that kind of experience? Have you ever been so doubtful about something, but still worshipped it, or believed that it would get better? For a moment, let's try to define love, or explain to your family member or spouse why you love her or him. Think about a list. These are generally the answers that might come to mind. You are beautiful, perhaps handsome, smart and funny. We have a lot in common. We enjoy the same things. You are fun to be with. You are a great cook. Or perhaps I'm attracted to you. You make me happy. We just clicked. I can't imagine my life without you. After a while, this list begins to sound shallow and a bit too much, because you know at a deep level that the list does not even begin to reflect or describe your love for that person. How can words ever describe or capture the beauty and mystery of two lives shared as one, given to, and received from each other? Can words ever fully describe and explain giving ourselves to another so completely that we live within the other and they within us, neither one losing themselves, but each one finding their true and complete self? I doubt it. My systematics theology and Christian ethics lecturer often said, language and words fail us. Some things like love can be experienced, but they can never be fully understood, explained, or even defined. So I never knew much about sunsets until I arrived in Hilton. And people like Joan Walk would say, I love taking pictures of the sun setting. And I never really understood what was the big deal about this until I took some time and watched the sunset and realized what a mystery yet beauty it was to watch and capture the sunset. So can you recall a time when you watched and captured a sunset? Even better, have you ever experienced the warmth of the sun in winter as it warms your skin and you felt a presence that had never been there before? Lights sparkled and trees danced, rocks and the river. How do you even begin to explain that? Is it just light in the air that's affected by the angle of the sun? I doubt so. I'm sure that a ray of color is more than water vapor floating in the atmosphere. Some things like beauty can be experienced, but they can never be fully or adequately expressed. They are always more than words. Have you ever held in your hands and wondered at the mystery of a newborn baby? How do you explain that? What words can describe that moment? We know the biology of reproduction, but we still can't wrap our heads around it. We don't look at the little one and see the result of the biological process. In that new life, we see and declare a miracle. These experiences are bigger, more beautiful, and beyond our minds could ever make sense of. We love and yet we doubt. We hold new life in our hands and yet we doubt. In these instances, doubt is a declaration that we have glimpsed the divine and touched the transcendent. It's our recognition that the experience is greater than our words can ever express or our minds can imagine. In the end, the experience is what we most want. It changes and transforms our lives in ways words, explanations, and concepts can never do that. If that's true about relationships, sunsets and babies, love, beauty, and new life, how could it not also be true about God? We worship, we doubt. We experience the real, but we cannot make sense of it. Despite the maths behind the Trinity, 3 = 1, 1 = 3, God is beyond words, explanation, or understanding. If the Trinity is anything, it is about love, beauty, and new life. We may not be able to explain this, but we know it when we experience it. The how of it all may be beyond our understanding, but that does not stop us from seeking it. God is ever calling and asking us to take our place amongst the three. Let us think about the story of the three men who visited Abraham. Three persons, distinct but not separate. They look just alike, though dressed in different colored robes. They share the same experience. Their bodies and posture are alike and form a circle of unity and oneness. Three persons, one life, one love, one beauty. That's the promise Jesus makes in today's gospel. I am with you always, Matthew 28:20. God before us, God behind us, God on our left, God on our right, God above us and beneath us, God within us and we within God. I am with you always. The Trinitarian life of God is to us what water is to a fish. It is our natural environment, and we are already in it. It is ever present, searching for or seeking God, as if God were absent, distant, or apart from us, is like a fish asking, where is the ocean? Maybe that's why Jesus begins his promise of his presence with these words, and remember, I am with you to the end of the age. Remember what already is. So what if today we do not only remember the words of Jesus' promise, but opening up ourselves to the experience of that promise? How might that experience change our lives? What would you dream or imagine? What strength, hope, or consolation might come with that experience? What might God do that would cause you to be left in wonder? Regardless of who you are, what you might have done or left undone, what has happened in your life, where you go, or what you encounter, the promise holds. The presence is real. And it's not a promise to be realized in the future. It's a promise that has already been and continues to be fulfilled. I am with you always. Like the disciples, we worship yet doubt, and the promise remains. I am with you always to the end of the age. Amen.
God for us, we call you Father. God alongside us, we call you Jesus. God within us, we call you Holy Spirit. You are the eternal mystery that enables, enfolds, and enlivens all things. Even us, and even me. Every name falls short of your goodness and greatness. We can only see who you are in what is. We ask for such perfect seeing, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Amen. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we approach you now in our own homes and as members of your body, the Church. We come with our inadequate words reflecting on the promise that you are with us to the end of the age. Open our hearts and minds afresh to the assurance and the possibility of this promise. In you, we have peace, meaning, purpose, courage, hope, dignity, healing, forgiveness, reconciliation, joy, love. And yet when we look with the eyes of the world, daily discouragement and despair are streamed into our homes. We wonder whom we can turn to for wise, humane and principled leadership. We yearn for a better, fairer, kinder world, and we mourn our own part in the general blindness. We fear for the future with so many poor, so many hungry, so many out of work, so many trapped in lives without prospects. So give us the clear-eyed faith of Jeremiah and Daniel, accepting the reality of the present, but holding on to the hope of restoration and living with integrity. Strengthen our discipleship in this time of testing. Refresh our sense of calling. Show us individually and as a church how to live faithfully in a broken world. And may we live day by day mindful of your great promise that you are with us always. Amen.
Trust that you will have your bread and wine ready, and just know that the God of the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, will be with you as God is with us as we celebrate this wonderful sacrament. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, most high God, for the beauty of your glory filling earth's sanctuary. So we cry, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, blessed be our triune God, now and forever.
Praise be unto you for the power of your still, small voice speaking new worlds into being. Thank you for creating us in your image, Holy Trinity. When we violate our created harmony, you forgive and make covenants with us out of your goodness. You free us and lead us in desert times, writing your law upon the stone tablets of our hearts, and call us to live in holy communion under your sovereign goodness.
So we cry,
Holy, Holy, Holy Lord,
blessed be our triune God, now and forever.
Especially we thank you for your word made flesh in Jesus Christ, who loved us as one of your own, and made us joint heirs of your goodness, though his teaching led to his death.
We praise you that in the presence of his betrayer, he took bread and said, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this in remembrance of me."
Then he was arrested, brutalized, hoisted on a cross, and left to die. But we give you thanks that nothing can extinguish your Holy Spirit. Christ was raised and now indwells us, even here, even now.
At this mystery we cry, Holy, holy, holy Lord, blessed be our triune God, now and forever. Come, Holy Spirit, brood over us once more to open our eyes to your presence. As we celebrate this foretaste of the banquet of your dominion, with joy we offer ourselves to you, remembering who you are, O great one in three. Amen. Amen. The bread which we break, is it not a sharing of the body of Christ?
We who are many are one body. For we all partake of the one bread.
So you are invited now, at home, wherever you find yourselves, to participate in this sacrament and to partake of the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, given for you, his blood shed for you. May the blessing of our triune God, who dwells in perfect convivial communion one with another, may the blessing of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you today and forever. Amen.
Remain in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
And Jesus said, "Go."